Hey, so like I had showed before, I have these picks and they have these gold leaves on them. And so all I did is pulled them off. And instead I want to add these green leaves. So it's as simple as this. You add a little glue and you just slide it in there. And any glue that's kind of left, as long as it's not too hot, I tend to burn myself a lot, then you just let it dry, set it aside. And so I'm gonna be doing this with all of these picks that I have for this wreath. The reason that they're different is, this is a wreath I made before in the fall. Well, I wouldn't say in the fall or for fall, but it was in the fall, but it was a winter wreath. And so I had used some old supply that was fall supply, and because it was fall supply, it was the green. And then they changed for winter to this more of a cream, glittery pick. So it came with a gold leaf. And also, some of these fell off, and I can use what's left on here by cutting, putting a little glue either on the stem or on the flower, and just pushing it down in. Get it nice and tight in there. And then I'm going to add a leaf. Just like so. So I'm going to do this to all of these stems. And I'm going to start this wreath today. Now just some more prep work for the wreath that I'm doing. It's going to have more of this green leaf in it, and so I'm just going to prep these by, this is just the extra that was left over without the flower on it. I just never throw any of this greenery away because it's always good for filler. So for this wreath, this is going to be filler, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to clip off all the extra. And so it's just one leaf on each. This one here I'm going to throw away, but for example, say I cut this one down and it has one of these little ends here that can easily add another leaf onto it. I'm going to keep that. That way if I find another leaf that can go on that, I'm going to put it right on it. No wasting here. Again, this is more that is going to go on the wreath that I'm going to be making. This is like a sparkly pine, and I'm not going to use the red berry. I actually use those on another wreath, and so I'll cut those off and put them aside. I'm always seem to be wearing black pants when I'm using glitter. This time of year, everything is full of glitter in my house and in my car, so this is what I'm gonna do. I'm going to cut off every stem and organize it to what it is. So here's one of them. Then I have a longer one that I use, and I actually cut the top of this off later. And then there is one with a small pine cone, frosty pine cone. Yeah, and that's it. Next, I have these berries, and what I do is I just pull the stems off, and later as I go, I'm going to cut some of these berries so they're not so long on the wreath. I think a lot of people don't see how much work it really is for every step to make a wreath. I mean, some wreaths don't take as long as others, especially if I've made so many, but this prep work is usually what takes the longest. And that's all I'll do for this one, and as I make the wreath, I'll cut it. So most of my wreaths are made from a grapevine base, and so I'm just going to be cleaning this grapevine wreath up as I'm prepping for the next wreath. We were hanging in the morning.